Welcome back, everyone, to Let's Play Shadows of the Damned. Last time, we defeated Justine for good and ended Act 4. Now we're beginning Act 5, which means we're now in the final stretch as we continue our way to the Castle of Hassel and Fleming. The door is behind us, is closed, of course.
This should take us right under the castle walls. Who's your skull, G?
You are, Johnson. My numbskull. You led us right into the catacombs.
Would that be really such a big deal? Because we can see these demon corpses here, but, isn't really everything in the underworld dead? Like, what does it mean to be dead here? Dead twice? Is it super dead? Like, is anything in hell really alive? But I guess they need catacombs for some reason.
It's hot as hell in here.
Yes, but it's a dry heat.
I hate humidity. So as we saw before, there's a few things in this room to look at. One is that force field. We haven't seen anything like that before. It's green and made of hexagons. See over here. Nothing there. There is a baby gate here. Lots of strawberry. And there is darkness behind it, so let's remember that. Alright, some darkness vines there. And the game did seem to want us to look over here. Alright, new enemy.
Is it just me, or is this juice jockey angrier than the others?
He looks ready to explode, and that's not a figure of speech.
Alright, this guy is either a big problem or no threat at all. You notice that QTE that popped up when he grabbed us? Yeah, that. B-B-X. If you can pass that QTE, he doesn't actually hurt you. If you fail the QTE, you die. So it's kind of an all-or-nothing thing. The weak points, as you might be able to guess, are the red things on his shoulders, because red things are weak points in this game. And instead of trying to target them individually, I find it easier to just shoot an explosive and try to get all of them at once. So we're going to try to use the hot boner. I got all of them. Alright. And yeah, that's the eyeball that we needed. So those guys, they can be a problem in groups of enemies because they're aggressive and they're fast. But by themselves, not too big of a deal as long as you can pass the QTE. Okay, right, he wanted a strawberry. And there's Willy. He wasn't there the first time. We know that the first gate wanted the eyeball, so let's head back there and get... Oh, of course. So, were they just lying there for Garcia's benefit, or do they usually sleep here? Were they just they didn't pop up the first time we went through here, so were they just thinking, hey guys, let's wait till he comes back, and then it'll be double the surprise? I mean, I guess maybe they knew that Garcia was going to have to double back. And maybe that makes a little sense. Kayla, and there's the strawberry. So. Oh, hold on. Yeah. One of those guys. You know what to do with them. As before, just have them roll into the wall and use our newly upgraded Skull Blaster on them. Not too difficult with this gun because if I can. Yeah. If I got clean shots on them, I would have been able to do that in two. But yeah, like I said last time, the Skull Blaster is the final upgrade to our weapons. Our three weapons are now in their final forms. Alright, the game now calling our attention to that green force field. Okay, two of these guys. That can be either a good thing or a bad thing. If you remember, these guys can, yeah, they can knock each other over. Like that. So you, if there's two of them, you kind of want to set them up so they're going to end up doing that. Yeah. Yeah, not much of a problem. Oh, right. Out of alcohol. Because I haven't been buying any, and I have needed to use what we had so far. So that could be a problem going forward. Alright, so we have this little closet full of darkness. And we have that force field over there. And we saw that there's a darkness core inside it. If we go back into the closet, we'll see the, yeah, that red line going into the core. You remember the darkness cores, we have to shoot them while we are standing in darkness. And this one is surrounded by a force field, so we have to get a shot over the force field. Previously, this would not have been possible, but now with the Skull Blaster, we can do this. Create a giant skull that shoots in an arc. It's the only weapon we have that can do something like this. So let's aim it and then step back. Okay, that looked like it went in. Yeah. We'll be doing that a few times. There are a few puzzles that require that. Hold on a second. Did I? No, there's a barrel over there. Oh, I'm glad I went back for that. That was just a hunch. And, yeah, so now that we have that, we actually have two red gems that we can spend. And I think the last time, yeah, last time I did anything was with the hot boner's capacity. But I don't know if that's really useful to use. I think we'll, yeah, the light shot. Because we have been using that. So I'll pump a couple into enemy stun time, because increasing the length of the light shot's effectiveness seems like that would be a better use than increasing increasing the capacity of the hot boner. Alright, we know she was dragged down there. And we also can see there's a baby gate. No, I still don't want to buy any alcohol, because we still might have the opportunity to buy red gems, so. Alright, yeah. Let's try down here. Another bit. You know, even if I know it's coming, the speed of that guy, along with the screaming music, actually does freak me out a little bit. It's not a scary game, but That part does do something to me. Let's put another in the light shot. All right. Okay, we want to remember we're going to need a brain, and we're going to need to bring it back here at some point. We can assume that the eyeball we have now goes here. Yep. Alright, let's see what's behind this. Well, great. Super. We needed a brain, right? Well, that's a pretty background. It looks like Fleming has his own unique bowling alley here. Okay, we have to shoot there. There's that green force field again, which represents that we're going to need the Skull Blaster in order to do this. So remember that big skull that we made doing this? Have to use it in a little bit of a different way here. Gonna have to roll it along. Oh, no. That was too high. Alright, shoot it a little lower, I think. And... oh! I thought it would take a lot longer. But I got it in that one try. And we got a brain as a reward. Oh, well, lucky us. Since we did it in one, let's just see what happens if you don't get a strike. You don't actually get a chance for a spare. They just all come back. And the ball retriever retrieves us a Paula head.
Ugh, this reminds me of the most horrid story. A gaggle of demon hags thought they could get ahead in the world by offering to join Fleming's harem. But he was so offended by their hideousness that he ripped off their heads and used the sloppy carcasses for bowling pins. Ever since, bowling for uglies has been one of his favorite forms of torture.
So instead of getting ahead, they lost a head?
This is nothing to joke about, G. Get your mind out of the gutter.
Oh, puns. Okay, and that took us back, yeah, we've been here before. Right, there's that vending machine. And, yeah, the gate that we need to put that brain in is down here. Right, the gate turned off, and, yeah. More sleeping demons. Pity we just couldn't have challenged Fleming in a bowling tournament to settle all this. Seems like that would have been an easier way of going about it. If we had only known that he liked to play. I do like that Garcia headbutts demons that have a giant horn on their forehead without a care. Alright. Alright, let's head on. Oh, there's a coffin, strangely.
Again.
She's not mental. She's momentarily confused.
Alright, yes. So, this is another part of the game that a lot of people don't really like. Because, there's a lot of obstacles in our way as we're trying to get away from Paula. and we didn't make it. This part actually can be a little difficult. Because the corridor that you're running in is tighter now and you have more obstacles in your way, and the, watch those textures load. You have a lot more in your way that you have to get rid of while Paula chases you.
I think your girl's gone mental again.
She's not mental. She's momentarily confused.
If you can keep your speed up all the way and not get caught on the walls like that, shoot the light back. See, how did she catch up to me so fast? I thought I was further ahead than that. Ordinarily, I might try to do a better run than this, but hey.
I think your girl's gone mental again.
She's not mental. She's momentarily confused.
I might as well leave this in just to show you why some people got frustrated at parts like this chase sequence. Because you might end up having to do it over and over again. Alright, we got past those obstacles, and yeah. That's all we really needed to do. Just get to that door, because she can't get through it. She'll just stand there forever. On the plus side, we are picking up alcohol, and we do really need it. We recognize those plugs. We saw that in Act 4. You have those guys who teleport between the plugs and shoot us with electricity. So let's take out those plugs.
It's times like these that I wish that guy from the cabin hadn't been torn into tiny little bits. We could use another gunman.
At least he and his woman are together now.
Now that you mention it, doesn't that mean his soul has been damned to the underworld? Kind of weird to picture him as one of those babies down the door.
That would be pretty funny if we encountered a door with that guy's face on it.
Quick, G!
Unfortunately, that doesn't happen. Can't be taking this kind of damage from these guys. Come on. And we're at the end of the game now. And alcohol is gonna be in short supply as we continue on. And as we go into the end game, why am I using the light shot? It'll just be needed more and more. Alright, are there any others? Any other plugs around? I can still hear those guys yelling, so there must be plugs around somewhere. Nah, this won't do at all. Okay, good. Because if this keeps up, gonna end up needing to buy alcohol. We just can't have it. We need to save all our money, all our gems, for Christopher, so we can get as many red gems as possible from him. All right, that should be the last plug, and that should be it for him. Looks like some coffins down there. Thank you, Willie. Yep, okay, good. I'm pretty happy with the alcohol situation now. Dark core. So I think we know what we... and nothing in there. We know what we need to do with that. Okay, a few directions we can go in there, but let's start off shooting that one. Alright, we saw a few cords around in here, so let's... Okay, yeah. There's a, as it says, a blindness hand covering a goat's head. It's the first time we've encountered one of those. It's a hand that will cover the head so we can't actually shoot the goat head and dispel the darkness. We can see that cord running to the darkness, blindness hand, so let's see where that goes. Alright, a few different cores. Sorry, cords. Most of these doors are blocked, so let's open the one we can get into. Okay, we got a heart when we went in there. No heart that time, so we are going to have to get out of this darkness, I think. And that door's not opening, so let's head back out. Yeah, there we go. I do like the alcohol situation, but I don't want to waste it, because we do have a long way to go, and I'm not really sure just how much more alcohol we'll be finding just lying around. Oh, okay, at least one more anyway. Great. And, okay. We know what to do here. We need to get out our skull blaster again. The developers seem to really like the idea that this shoots in an arc. Because they do have you do it a few times in these areas. Yep, there's another one. Alright. Another in the light shot. Almost upgraded that light shot stun time to its max, so that's good. Now, we need another... Okay, there's another unlocked door, and... Okay, got a heart when we went in here. And that should be the last door. The one that the blue cord is running towards. So let's see what we find in there. We find a... What is that? I don't know what that is, but whatever it is, we'll shoot it because it's disgusting. Alright. Went through all that just to get rid of that hand so we can shoot that goat head. It's one of the longer and more elaborate scenes where you have to get rid of darkness. And yeah, they don't seem to know what to do. Let's not even bother with them. Can see another blue cord. Yeah. Oh, hey. Chris. And we, yeah.
I know y'all want to stay on the down low, but the catacombs? Well, that's crazy talk.
It's a funny joke. It's funny. We almost had enough to buy two, but only one for us. I like how the alignment of Garcia's hand and Christopher's mouth usually doesn't work. More often than not. Okay, yeah. Enemy stun time maxed out. It's supposed to be that Garcia's hand goes in Chris's mouth, but usually the animation doesn't work that way. And we can see the blindness hand and the cord running in there. So let's see. Oh, yeah. You remember what we need to do with that guy? It's actually been a little while since we've encountered one of these guys, hasn't it? How did he hit me through the wall? Alright, can't get a good shot from here. Oh, but his eye does go through the wall, so let's shoot him through that. And he can also double axe handle us through the wall, and, oh, it's It's one another. It's the blindness hand root. Alright, so we got rid of that, and... this isn't working very well. But we do remember that there were a couple ways to kill one of these guys. One of them is just straight up shooting him in the eye until he dies, but there was a second way. And that is, for whatever reason, darkness actually kills this guy. Well, he can charge at us. And then more demons come out of him if you do that. So we can unleash this crawler, and you know what he does? He'll go up to the goat head and bring on the darkness. We do have to fight the demons that come out of this giant if we do this, and... But that just might be easier to do it that way. Okay, there we go. Nope. First thing we have to do is make sure he doesn't... Oh, bad time to reload. Alright. Okay, so now all it is just we have to kill a couple normal demons. Oh. Well, that's not good. What do you think of the trend of in video games of when you get hurt, the edges of the screen become bathed in a color? Like in this one, if you get hurt, you get a lot of red encroaching onto the screen. Is that a good thing? Kind of obscures visibility, which you don't need if you're about to die. I mean, it makes it... Okay, he doesn't... He needs something else. Okay. It makes it clear that you're about to die, sure, and that's a good thing to know, but... I never really liked that idea. Alright, this door's open now. Oh, it's Paula. Now this part can be a problem if you forget that you can stun her with the light shot. Which is what I forgot the first time I did this. Because if you do forget that, you kind of have to make her chase you around this whole area to try to get around and get to the strawberry. Yeah, there you go. A lot of opening doors to get the keys in these levels, it seems. Now... Let's creep in here and see if Paul is anywhere to be found. No, she's not. She vanishes after that part. I'm trying to remember if that's the last chase scene with Paula in the game. It might be. But here we are at the big door, which means it's time for the level to end. And with that, Area 5-1 is completed. We now continue ever closer to the castle with 5-2. See you next time.